With its latest flagship, OnePlus introduced a ton of new features to the Oxygen OS. From a handy video enhancer to a RAM booster, the latest version of OnePlus's custom Android skin definitely packs in a lot. But at the end of the day, the native features can only do so much, and there are certain areas where the OS could do better. For instance, it still doesn't have a feature-rich image editor or a powerful note-taking app. And you'll need to rely on third-party apps to fill that gap. Hey guys, this is Abhijit from Guiding Tech, and in this video, we'll talk about some cool apps for your new OnePlus 7 Pro that you must download if you want to maximize its potential. And needless to say, these will work on the OnePlus 7 as well. So let's get right to it, shall we? Kicking things off is Firefox Focus, a great privacy-focused browser for your phone that's far better than Chrome if you're serious about keeping your data private. The browser offers a completely private browsing experience right out of the box, which means that there's no need for you to use the incognito mode. On top of that, it also features anti-tracking capabilities, which will block websites from collecting data about your browsing patterns. Staying true to its name, Firefox Focus also provides you with a tap-free browsing experience so that you can completely focus on the website you're on without getting distracted by any other tabs in the background. So if you ask me, this is one of the browsers which is good if you want to focus on browsing one particular website at a time. But if you are used to browsing multiple sites, then you'd have to rely on other mainstream browsers like Chrome, of course. Next up, there's Snapseed, one of the most powerful image editing apps from Google, which is a must-have for any device, not just the OnePlus 7 Pro. And we absolutely love it, and that's why we keep including it in every such list. The app gives you access to a large variety of tools which will let you do everything from basic image tuning to more advanced edits like spot healing and double exposure. It's also a great option for those of you who like to use the Pro mode and capture photos in RAW thanks to its native RAW image editor. I've been using this app for a couple of years now, and believe me when I say, Snapseed is not an app that you should miss. While we are on the topic of image editing, there's another app that you should check out, and that's called Panorama Crop. As the name suggests, the app essentially lets you perfectly crop your panorama shots for platforms like Instagram. But in this case, there's another use for it. The OnePlus 7 Pro packs an impressive wide-angle lens which you can use to capture some amazing landscape shots. But because of their unique dimensions, you might face issues posting them on Insta. Panorama Crop can help you with that as well. With a single tap, you can chop up your wide-angle shots into two or more parts so that you can upload them seamlessly in a single post. Next up, we have the Solid Explorer, which is a great replacement for the stock file manager that doesn't offer much in terms of features. With the app, you'll be able to manage all the files on your system, archive files that aren't of immediate use, and see all your clipboard content in one place, and easily transfer files between folders with the dual panel mode. If you're someone who's particular about keeping their phone's internal storage nice and organized, then you shouldn't think twice before downloading Solid Explorer. Much like the stock file explorer, the built-in Notes app on the OnePlus 7 Pro is also quite limiting. It can't take backups of your notes, doesn't let you add collaborators, and has no cross-platform support. In short, it's not meant for power users. The Microsoft To-Do app is a great alternative that you should check out instead. It includes all the features that I mentioned earlier, along with a couple of other useful ones that make it one of the best note-taking apps out. The only possible downside of using it over the stock app is that you won't be able to see all your notes and tasks on the shelf unless you add a dedicated widget. Next up, there's Quick, a handy video editor that you can use if you use your phone to make videos or photo slideshows, something that you won't be able to do as well with the stock video editor. The app is easy to use, and with it, you'll be able to easily stitch your photos or videos together with a single tap. On top of that, the app also has an extensive library of copyright-free music and transitions that you can use to spice things up a bit. Let's move on to another essential app that I recommend for pretty much all Android phones in general. Well, Microsoft's SMS Organizer. If you haven't used it before, then you should get this one right away. And again, this is one of those apps which is pretty much part of all our lists. It's arguably the most feature-rich SMS app I've used by far, which not only organizes your messages into separate folders, but also blocks spam and takes regular backups of your inbox on Google Drive. However, there's one minor issue. Well, it's not exactly minor. The SMS Organizer app is only available in India for now, and you won't be able to use it in any other region. But for those of you who aren't in India, I've got a different alternative, and that's Textra. Textra app definitely isn't as powerful as the SMS Organizer, but it does offer some handy features. With the app, you can schedule messages, use gestures to navigate through your inbox, and archive important messages without accidentally deleting them. Next up, we have not one, but two offline music players, which are also essential downloads if you still haven't given in to the online music streaming craze. The Play Store is home to a number of different music players, but the Black Player and PowerAmp are my personal favorites. Not only do they include support for a variety of different file formats, they also come with the advanced equalizer settings and presets, which is a necessity if you're listening to high quality lossless files. So try this out and let us know which one you prefer the most. Now, rounding things off is the KM Player, which is a good alternative to the stock video player because it brings support for most popular file formats. On top of that, it also lets you play 4K HDR videos without any hiccups, which will let you make the most of the HDR 10+ certified display on your phone. But there's a slight catch. The player needs a couple of custom codecs to play 4K videos. Well, don't worry, we've got you covered. The codecs are linked in the description below, and all you need to do is download them onto your phone and install them by navigating to the preferences section within the KM Player settings. Well, that's it for today's video. Make sure you check out all the apps from the links in the description below. And while you're at it, don't forget to hit the like button if you like the video, subscribe to GT for more such videos, and if you know of any other apps which would really suit your OnePlus 7 or OnePlus 7 Pro, please do talk about them in the comments. This is Abhijit signing off. I'll see you guys in the next one.